on God's right hand side.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. And we thank God for all the saints of God. And I thank God for my own wife and helper.
God bless you.
Yes, Lord. Deacon Turner to the saints of God. Amen. We thank God for Aunt Sam coming out to worship with us. Amen. We thank God for having you in our midst. Amen. On tonight. We thank God for Deacon Turner and Sister Turner. Safe travel. Amen. Just came back from the Big Easy. Man, I got a question. Was it easy? Amen. Amen. So we thank God for giving them safe travel. Amen. And we give God praise and we give him glory. Amen. So let's get some more Jesus while we're sitting here. Yes, open your heart up to him. Before you leave, God will touch you. Yes, you got expectation in your heart. Believe God. Amen.
Amen.
Matthew, the third chapter. Matthew, the third chapter. I could have stayed there in worship, but I know we got to move on.
Yes, Lord.
There's nothing like his presence.
Yes.
Mm. Being in his presence. Amen. Matthew, the third chapter, verse 11 and 12. The scripture I will deal with on tonight. Matthew, the third chapter. Verse 11 and 12. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Matthew, the third chapter, verse 11 and 12. When you have it, could you please say amen?
Amen.
I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I'm not worthy to carry. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire, whose fan is in his hand. And he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the barn. But he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor,
you need
the Holy Ghost
and fire.
Say, neighbor,
you need
the Holy Ghost
and fire.
Say, neighbor,
you need
the Holy Ghost,
and
fire.
And fire.
Because saints of God speaking in tongues, we want to move beyond just the speaking in tongues. We want to move beyond just the dancing and the shouting and the foot stomping. Do you hear me, saints of God? We want to move beyond just the jumping and leaping and rolling out in the floor. And don't get me wrong, saints of God, all those things are good. The shouting is good because the Holy Ghost will make you shout. The praising God is good because the Holy Ghost will make you praise God.
Yes.
We ought to enter his gates with thanksgiving and come into his courts with praise.
Yes.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes.
The dancing is good because the Holy Ghost will make you dance.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost will make you shout. The Holy Ghost will make you lift up holy hands.
Yes.
It's hard to sit there when the Holy Ghost is moving. If the Holy Ghost is down on the inside of you, don't nobody got to tell you to lift your hands.
Yes.
If the Holy Ghost is living down on the inside of you, don't nobody got to tell you to stomp your feet. If the Holy Ghost is living down on the inside of you, don't nobody got to tell you to take off running. Do you hear me, saints of God? Because it's something about the Holy Ghost that'll make you praise God and worship God and magnify God. And you don't need no cheerleader. Do you hear me, saints of God? Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. But saints of God, we got to get beyond just the gifts of the Spirit of God from it. And we got to get beyond just the speaking in tongues and get beyond just the dancing and the shouting. Do you hear me, saints of God? We got to move over to Holy Ghost and fire. Everybody talking about the Holy Ghost, but what about the fire? Because the Bible says that you're going to be baptized with the Holy Ghost and fire. And I want to make sure that I'm baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. It's something about fire when it get on you, it'll make you move. It's something about fire that when it get touch, it begins to transform. And this is the reason why I come, I need Holy Ghost and fire in my life. Do you hear me? I need to be transformed.
Yes, Lord.
I can't transform myself. I need Holy Ghost and fire. I need Holy Ghost fire down in my hands. Do you hear me? I need Holy Ghost fire down in my feet. Do you hear me, saints of God? All if you're going to run over Jesus, you're going to need Holy Ghost fire down inside your feet. Do you hear me? I need Holy Ghost fire down inside my belly. All I need to be like Jeremiah. He said, I told God I was going to stop preaching his word. He said, I'm going to wasn't going to say nothing else about Yahweh, about the great I am. He said, I wasn't going to say nothing else about El Shaddai, and about Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, and Jehovah Shalom, and Jehovah Tishkenu. He said, I wasn't going to say anything else about Jehovah Nissi and Jehovah Shalom. But he said, when I tried to keep my mouth closed, he said, his word was like a fire shot down inside my bones. And I want the fire of God to be shut down inside of my bones. Lord, I need your fire.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Holy Ghost and fire. Holy Ghost and fire. Oh, my God. Yeah. Let's just move away from the clapping. Let's just move away from the dancing. And let's make sure that we embrace Holy Ghost and fire.
Holy Ghost and fire.
John the Baptist. Was the person that began to tell them about the Holy Ghost and fire.
Uh-huh.
Now you got to remember now that John the Baptist was filled with the Holy Ghost even while he was in his mother's womb.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Go to Luke. I'm going to show you something. Go to Luke, the first chapter.
My God.
See, this is the reason why we need to let the Holy Ghost have his way.
Uh-huh.
Because I want to go a whole different way. But the Holy Ghost is taking me a whole different way.
Yes,
and I want to go by his lead.
Yes, Lord. Thank
you. Will you hear me, saints of God?
Thank you.
Oh, my God. Look in Luke chapter 1. Verse 15.
Hallelujah.
This is John the Baptist speaking about the Holy Ghost and fire. Mm-hmm. But John was filled with the Holy Ghost even when he was in his mother's womb.
Yes,
oh my God, look at Luke chapter 1, verse 15. For this is the angel speaking to Elizabeth, now John's mother.
Uh-huh.
He said, for he shall be great in the sight of the Lord, and should drink neither wine nor strong drink.
Uh-huh.
He should be filled with the Holy Ghost even from his mother's womb.
Yes.
Okay, now go to Luke. I mean, verse 41, that same chapter. I'm finna show you what is happening now. I'm finna show you something. Look at Luke, verse 41. Oh my God. You there? And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. Look at verse 44. Look what Elizabeth told Mary. Mary, who was the mother of Jesus, she said, for lo, as soon as I heard your voice, she said, as soon as the voice of your solution sounded in my ears, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. Why? Because Mary was carrying Jesus. But Elizabeth was carrying John the Baptist. We know that John the Baptist was the prophet who was sent before Jesus to make his way straight. But when Mary walked in the house, because the angel told Mary, he said, listen, he said, your cousin Elizabeth is going to get ready to have a child in her old age. So Mary went to her house to see if the thing was true. When she walked in the house and she saluted Elizabeth, the Bible said that the baby John the Baptist that was on the inside of her womb said that John the Baptist leaped inside the womb when he heard Mary's voice. It's something about somebody who is filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That when they speak to you, something inside your belly begins to leap.
Yes.
And I want to be around people who get Holy Ghost fire down inside their belly. That when they speak to me, something in my belly leaps.
Yes.
All the purpose of God. I'm praying with purpose. But when I need somebody to speak to me that will make that purpose leap on inside my belly.
Yes.
I don't want to be around nobody who don't got no Holy Ghost and fire. But I need to be around somebody when they speak to me. Purpose leap up in my belly.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? Life lift up inside my belly. Yeah. Living waters begin to flow out of my belly. Do you hear me, Chase?
Yeah.
All the fire of God begins to flow from my belly. You need somebody to speak in your ear to make your baby loose. Is something about hearing a man or a woman of God that the Holy Ghost and fire is living down on the inside. You can be thinking about giving up on God, but when you get through talking to them, you say, I shall live and I die in the cloud of glory of God. You can say, all you can think you can be down in a depressed place, and storms can be all around you, but when you get around somebody who got Holy Ghost and fire,
hey!
It seems like the storm is dissipating. Do you hear me, saints of God? I need to be around some saints who got the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Hallelujah,
Jesus.
Yes, Hallelujah. Hallelujah,
Lord. Feel with the Holy Ghost, even from the womb. And John the Baptist here is telling the people while he was baptizing them in the Jordan.
Yes.
They was coming to John. And John was baptizing them unto repentance.
Uh-huh.
Because you can't get Holy Ghost in fire if you don't repent, do you really? Repent means to change your mind. It means to reconsider. It means to change from your ways. Do you hear me say to God? Some of us are asking God for the Holy Ghost in fire, but we refuse to repent. But you got to change your mind. You got to take over the mind of Jesus. If you want Holy Ghost in fire, if you want the fire of God and the power of God to flow in your life, you got to repent. You got to change your mind. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Do not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. Your mind needs to be renewed. Do you hear me say to God? If you want Holy Ghost and fire,
yes, Lord.
We came down for repentance. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. And when it came down to be baptized, he said, I'm baptizing you with water unto repentance. He said, you came down and confessed your sins. He said, you have repented. I'm baptizing you in water. But he said, it's somebody that's coming after me.
Yes.
That's more mightier than I am. He said, I'm not even worthy to carry his shoes. He was speaking about Jesus. Since God wants to speak to you about something, if you really want Holy Ghost and fire. Because something that John the Baptist had, he had humility. He said, I am not even worthy to even carry his shoes. We can't think that we're worthy to receive anything from God. But oh God, I know that I'm not worthy, oh God. The only reason why I'm worthy is because of the blood of Jesus. It was your righteousness that was imputed to me, oh God. Do you hear the taste of God? We don't get arrogant, we don't get prideful because we are not worthy of the things of God. But he learned about humility.
Yes.
God resists the proud, but give grace to the humble.
Yes, Lord.
God resists the proud. Resist means to take your stand against. Because when you're prideful, God will take his stands against you.
Yes.
You're prideful, but you're asking God for the Holy Ghost, but God will take his stand against you. Why? Because God can't stand pride. It was Lucifer who was in heaven who got over to pride because of the way that he looked. And let me tell you something, pride cannot tarry in the presence of God. God's not going to fill you with the Holy Ghost and with fire as long as you're walking in pride.
Come
the Bible said, God, resist the proud.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, no, Shonda. Proud. Oh, my God. Proud. Proud. Proud means arrogant.
Yes.
It means to be disdainful. When you feel like God ain't worthy. Do you hear me? When a person is disdainful towards God, that means they look at God as not being worthy. This is the reason why they won't lift their hands in the house of God. This is the reason why they won't open their mouth and praise God, because they got a disdain towards God. They got a disdain towards the people of God, but yet they want Holy Ghost and fire. Yet they want God to heal them. Yet they want God to deliver them. Oh God, save my children. Oh God, touch my body. Oh God, touch my mind. Touch my heart. No, God ain't finna touch nothing because you operate in pride. But if you want God to touch you, if you want Holy Ghost and fire, if you want to walk in the dunamis of God, if you want to walk in the dynamite power, if you want to walk in the things of God, do you hear me say, God, you got to get down to a low place.
Yes.
Because God resists the proud, but gives grace up to the humble.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Proud. Proud. People don't get the Holy Ghost and fire. Pride stops the Holy Ghost from flowing. Oh my God. If you can show me a prayerful house, I'll show you a place where the Holy Ghost is not speaking and where the Holy Ghost is not moving, because the leaders are too prideful.
Come on.
Do you hear me say, God? There is a disdain in their heart for God. Pride. Pride means to think more of yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
Than what you are.
Yeah.
It's trying to be more than what God directs you to be.
Yeah.
Proud. Oh, my God. Means selfie. Because a prideful person is always thinking about themselves. But a person that is humble do not lean on their own strength. Do you hear me? A person that is humble leans on God. A person that is humble said, I will lift up my eyes up to the hill from which coming my help. My help coming from God. Sometimes the Holy Ghost can't flow in your life because you got too much pride. You always want to take a selfie. Driving down the street, you want to take a selfie. Do you hear me say, God? All these are all about me, and it ain't about God. But Jesus said, if I be lifted up, he said, I will draw all men unto me. If you want Holy Ghost and fire, you learn how to humble yourself.
Hallelujah.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, my God.
Yes,
John said, I am not worthy.
Uh-huh.
He had a revelation of humility.
Oh, yes.
I'm not worthy to carry his shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Can I tell you, Pastor, is not worthy to stand up before you and preach this word right now?
Mm.
I'm not worthy. I haven't dotted every I and crossed every T.
Mm-hmm.
My background says I'm not worthy.
Yes.
But the blood of Jesus says I'm worthy.
Hey.
Do you hear me say, God? And this is the reason why I come. You got to get up under the blood. And you got to stay up under the blood. Because it's the blood that makes you worthy.
Yes.
It's the blood that qualifies you for Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes.
It's the blood that qualifies you for the breath of God. It's the blood that qualifies you for dunamis power. It's the blood. Not worthy to carry his sandals. Carrying somebody's sandals back in his time was for the lowest slave.
Yes.
But he said, I'm not even worthy to do the least.
Uh-huh.
He said, one is coming after me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, that is more mightier than I. Whose shoes I'm not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes,
he said, I'm baptizing you with water. But he said, when Jesus, the Son of God, come, he said, when the Lamb of God show up, he said, when the lily of the valley show up, he said, when the bright and morning stars show up, he said, when the line of the tribe of Judah show up, he said, when your great high priest and your mediator show up, do you hear me say to God? He said, when the Son of God show up, he said, when the bread of life show up, he said, when the light of the world show up, he said, when the true vine show up, he said, when the word that was made flesh show up, he said, he's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. Baptized means to dip under.
Uh-huh.
When a person is baptized, their little sprinkling stuff, that ain't baptized. That ain't baptism.
Uh-uh.
Baptized means to dip under. When you look the word up, it means to dip under.
Uh-huh.
He said, listen, I'll baptize you in the water. But the Holy Ghost is, but he said, but when the Holy Ghost come, he said, Jesus going to baptize you in the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
He said, Jesus is going to take you under in the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
Baptize means to submerge.
Uh-huh.
Submerge means to take under.
Uh-huh.
He said, when the Holy Ghost come over you, he said, God is going to put you under the influence of the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
Listen to me, saints of God. When a person submerge, a submarine will go down because it's submerging. Do you hear me? Which means that it's high. When he said the Holy Ghost is going to baptize you, he is saying the Holy Ghost is going to come over you and going to hide you. Because let me tell you something, saints of God. You need the Holy Ghost to hide you. Your problem is when God submerged you and when God baptized you in the Holy Ghost, you keep on sticking your head up. When you hear saints of God, because flesh keep on sticking his head up. So when God submerged you, God is trying to hide you in a secret place. That's what the songwriter said. He said, God, hide me in your secret place. When God hides you in a secret place, God is baptizing you in the Holy Ghost. God is trying to keep you down. But your flesh keep on rising up. But God, I need you to baptize me all over again. God, baptize me again. God, fill me all over again. God, touch me all over again. God, stir me all over again. God, empower me all over again. I need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Hide me, oh God, in your pavilion. Hide me, oh God, from danger. Hide me, oh God, from myself, oh God. I need to be baptized in Holy Ghost and fire.
Thank you, Lord.
It stops your flesh from looking up.
Oh, my God.
Because God got you submerged.
Yes, Lord.
Baptized means to immerse.
Yes.
Now, submerge and immerse almost sound like they're the same. Because both of them means to be underwater.
Yes.
But submerge means to hide under the water.
Yes.
Immerse means to be covered in holy. When you get immersed in water, that means that you are covered holy in water. And God, I need the Holy Ghost to cover me holy, oh God. I don't just need a little sprinkling, but God, I need you to cover me with the Holy Ghost and fire. God, I need you to immerse me. John the Baptist says, when the Holy Ghost comes, he's going to immerse you.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
My God.
His power.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Hallelujah.
Whenever a person go up under water,
yes, Lord.
You are really up under that water's influence.
Yes, Lord.
Because the weight of that water, the pressure of that water is upon you. The wetness of that water is upon you. You really up under that water's influence. And this is what it means to be filled with the Holy Ghost. It means to be up under the influence of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
When a person say, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost, they're saying, I'm up under the Holy Ghost influence.
Yes.
He influenced the way that I talk. He influenced the places that I go. He influenced the way that I act. He influenced the way that I think. Do you hear me? Because I'm up under the influence of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And what some of us need to do, we need to get up under the influence of the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
we are under the influence of everybody else except for the Holy Ghost. Uh-huh. But you need to get up under the influence of the Holy Ghost in fire.
Yes,
he said,
Lord.
I'm going to baptize you.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
I said, Jesus, I'm going to baptize you with Holy Ghost and with fire.
Yes,
we know that the Holy Ghost is the comforter.
Uh-huh.
We know that the Holy Ghost is the helper.
Uh-huh.
We know that the Holy Ghost is the spirit of truth.
Uh-huh.
We know that the Holy Ghost is the intercessor.
Uh-huh.
Because the Bible said we do not know how we ought to pray. But the Holy Ghost make intercession for us. Do you hear me, saints of God?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you just do not know what to say. It's something about being filled with the Holy Ghost. It been times I went into the prayer room, I didn't know what to say. It been times my heart was very heavy, I didn't know what to say. It was times I was discouraged, I didn't know what to say. But I went into the prayer room, do you hear me, saints of God? And I got down on my face, and I started talking to God. But it seemed like the words weren't coming out. But sooner or later, the Holy Ghost stepped right on in and began to make intercession. Do you hear me, saints of God? According to the will of God, the mind of God, it says the spirit of God. You need the Holy Ghost to make intercessions for you.
Yeah.
Pray for me, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Tell the Father what I'm feeling, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm kind of weary right now.
Yeah.
I'm kind of depressed right now. I'm kind of stressed right now. I don't got the word to say in English, but when the Holy Ghost started talking, all he started speaking with a heavenly language, I need the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord.
That's how come the Holy, the devil don't want you to get the Holy Ghost. He don't want you to pray in your heavenly language. Do you hear me? Because when the Holy Ghost started talking, the devil don't understand what he's saying. Do you hear me, saints of God? That's how come you need the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
The comforter.
Yes.
You're going to be baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes, Lord.
Holy Ghost brings dunamis power.
Yes,
Jesus said after the Holy Ghost come upon you, you're going to receive power. That word in the Greek means dunamis.
Mm-hmm.
Where we get the word dynamite.
Yes.
He said, when the Holy Ghost come on you, you're going to get dynamite power.
Yes.
Do you hear that? So when Jesus baptized you in the Holy Ghost, when you go down and come up, you should come up with some dynamite power.
Yes.
Do you hear me, saints of God? All I can tell when you've been baptized in the Holy Ghost, because when you come back up, you're going to come up with dynamite power.
Yes.
Dunamis power is God's energy.
Oh, yes.
It's God's ability.
Yes,
it's God's might. When you get baptized in the Holy Ghost, you come back up with God's energy.
Yes.
You come back up with God's might. Do you hear me, God? You come back up with I can power and I will power and I able power. Do you hear me, sense of God? All I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
It's not my strength. It's not my wisdom. It's not my resources. But it's the power of God. I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost. God, tonight baptize me, oh God.
Hey.
I need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. I'm tired of this dead life, oh God. I'm tired of these evil ways, oh God. I'm tired of the darkness, oh God. I'm tired of the confusion, oh God. Baptize me in the Holy Ghost. That's my name.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I seek you, God. I seek you for Holy Ghost and fire.
Yeah.
I call out to you, God, for Holy Ghost and fire. I push my plate back, oh God, for Holy Ghost and fire. I humble myself, oh God, for Holy Ghost and fire. Oh my God, I change my mind. I reconsider my ways, oh God, for Holy Ghost and fire. Baptize you in the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
In fire.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
When you get baptized in the Holy Ghost, you come back up with the mind of God.
Ah.
Oh, you went down with that fleshly mind. But when you come up with the mind of God. How do I know that? Because the Bible says, who knows the mind of God? Save the spirit of God. When you get the Holy Ghost, you get the mind of God.
Uh-huh.
You start thinking different. Do you hear me, saints of God? You start thinking just like God. Do you hear me? I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost, and my thinking is different.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Baptized with Holy Ghost.
My God.
And fire.
Yes, Lord.
Mm.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
To some of us that's seeking God. To be filled with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes.
Keep on waiting.
Yes.
Keep on seeking him.
Yes, Lord.
He said he's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, no,
my God.
Look at verse 12. I'm going to show you something now. Because I told you earlier, you need Holy Ghost and fire.
Yes.
This is the reason why come you need Holy Ghost and fire. Look at verse 12.
My God.
I'm going to show you something about what the fire of God does. My God, look what he says. John says, whose fan, oh my God, is in his hand. And he will thoroughly purge his floor. Talking about Jesus now. And gather, oh my God.
Yes, Lord.
He will thoroughly purge his floor. And gather his wheat into the barn.
Yes.
But he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. John said that Jesus' fan was in his hand. What was he talking about when he said Jesus' fan was in his hand? He was speaking about wheat now. I want you to catch this revelation now. Because back in his time, when a fan was a wooden pitchfork that they used to throw wheat in the air. Do you hear me? And when they throw that wheat in the air, the wind would hit that wheat and will carry away the chaff and carry away the debris. Now, saints of God, I'm going to show you what the fire of God does in your life. This is the reason why come you need the fire of God. I want to take you through this process now, because before grain really become grain, they pull the wheat out the field. There is a process they got to go through. They get that wheat and they put it on a round rocky area. They get some oxes. And those oxes go out there, and what they be trying to do, they be trying to separate the wheat from the stalk. Do you hear me, saints of God? So what they will do is, they will let those big old oxes walk on that wheat to remove that wheat from the stalk. Do you hear me, saints of God? This is the first process of the fire of God. Because the first thing that God want to do when the fire of God is flowing is that God want to separate some stuff that should be connected to you.
Come on.
I told you that the wheat is connected to the steel. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
It's connected, and it got to be broke off from the thing that it grew up with. Some of us are still connected to stuff because we grew up with it. It have been a support system for so long. But God is trying to get you to a point now where God begins to separate you from stuff that you think that is your support system. When the Holy Ghost and fire, when fire is flowing in your life, God begins to do a separation. Do you hear me? The fire of God comes to separate you from stuff that you do not need. But I told you that those oxes was very heavy. Almost 500 to 800 pounds.
Jesus.
They would walk on that wheat. And when they walked on it, that wheat was separated from that stem. Heaviness. The heaviness of those oxes. I said the heaviness. They use weight. They use heaviness. Some of y'all ain't caught it yet. They use weight. They use heaviness. Oh, some of y'all got it. Because when you deal with the glory of God, when you deal with the kabod of God, kabod in Hebrew means heaviness. And this is something that the Holy Ghost bring in your life. He brings the heaviness of God. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
I need God to weigh heavy in my life. Do you hear me? Say God. I need the glory of God to flow so God can separate from me everything that I don't need. Stuff that I thought was a support system, God. Let your glory come down in my life and separate, oh God. Separate everybody from your God that's keeping me out your presence. Separate me, oh God, from stuff that I'm dependent upon, oh God. Your glory, oh God. Let your provide, God. Let your heaviness, oh God. Let the glory of the Holy Ghost, how that will shade, come down in my life. The first step is the separate stage. But then the fan that he was talking about, Jesus had in his hand,
my God.
This is when you call the winnowing stage. They called it winnowing because the wind had to hit the grain. They will get that grain with that wooden pitchfork. They were throwing it in the air.
Yes.
And when they threw it in the air, the wind would hit it. The grain would fall back down.
Yes.
But the chaff and the debris would be blown away.
Yes.
This is when you deal with the wind of the Holy Ghost. Did you hear me say to God? Because when the wind of the Holy Ghost is blowing in your life, he begins to blow away the debris.
Uh-huh.
He begins to blow away everything that's stopping you from getting closer to God. I need the wind of God. This is the reason why the Holy Ghost in fire is so important in your life, saints of God, because the Holy Ghost brings the wind of God. God blow everything away, oh God. That's not like you, oh God. We need the wind of God.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord. Thank you.
Wind of wind. We ain't hit it. Sometimes it seems like God, my life is being tossed up and coming back down.
My God.
Yes,
tossed up and coming back down. I want you to understand, saints of God, that they had to wait until the wind was blowing before they threw up the grain.
My God.
Saints of God, it's a time and season for the winds of God to blow.
Yes.
Sometimes God's wind is blowing in his house, but we're not in the proper place. But when you feel the winds of God blowing, that's the time for you to get on the altar. When you feel the winds of God blowing, that's the time for you to reach out to God. When you feel the winds of God blowing, that's the time for you to begin to magnify and praise and worship God. When you feel the winds blowing, don't sit there with your hands folded. When you feel the winds of God blowing, because the wind of God is blowing to bring about deliverance. The wind of God is blowing to deliver your life. The wind of God is blowing so God can turn around. The wind of God is blowing so he can bring restoration. The wind of God is blowing so he can bring revival. The wind of God is blowing so he can bring renewal. The wind of God is blowing so he can bring direction. You need the wind of the Holy Ghost. Hold your wings across my mind. And blow away everything that's not like your God. Let your winds hit my spirit, man, oh God. And blow away everything that's not like your God. Oh God, I need your wind, oh God. I need your breath, oh God. Blow in my life, oh God. Blow everything that's not like your God. The Bible says,
my God.
God formed Adam of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostril the breath of life. When he first formed Adam, he just was a body. He wasn't moving. He wasn't thinking. He didn't have no purpose. He didn't have no function. But as soon as the wind of God hit his nostril, Adam began to raise up. Do you hear me? Adam began to name all the animals. You know why? Because he had the breath of God living down on the inside of him. And you need the wind of God. You need the breath of God to blow in your life so God can bring you back from the dead.
Some of us
have been dead spiritually for a long time.
My God.
Some of us have been stuck in a certain place for a long time. Some of us haven't felt the touch of God in a long time. Some of us have sat up and we got bitter. We don't know the move of God anymore. But saints of God, can I tell you, you need to get up under the wind of God. You need the breath of God to blow in your life, saints of God. Can you hear me? You need the wind of God.
Yes, Lord.
The wind will blow away the debris. I'm coming to a close. The wind will blow away the chaff. It took the wind of God.
Hallelujah.
The Holy Ghost always brings the wind of God.
Yes.
God been blowing in my life for so many years.
Yes.
And I've seen so many things shoot past me.
Yes.
But the things that he blew away, I didn't need.
Amen.
Sometimes when we see stuff flying away, we try to catch it.
Yes.
But let the wind of God blow it away.
Yes.
I don't care if it's a man, I don't care if it's a woman. If you see no fire past you, it ain't nothing but the wind of God. Blow it away, do you hear me?
Hallelujah.
The wind.
My God.
Will blow things away.
Yes, Lord.
The grain will fall back down to the ground.
Yes, Lord.
They will get the grain and put it in what they call a sieve. A sieve was a round pan-like structure. They would get all that grain and put it in that sieve. Why was they doing it? Because inside of the grain you had weed seeds, you had straw, you had debris. That was down inside of the grain. So what they would do, they would get that seal, and they would put that grain inside that seal, and they would shake it. Why were they shaking it? They were shaking it because the stuff that was in the bottom had to be shook until it came up to the top. This is what we need, says to God. This is the reason why you need the Holy Ghost in fire, because you need the Holy Ghost to shake some stuff up in your life.
Yes.
All that you do, saints of God, is some stuff that's buried deep You hear me? Oh God, I need you to shake some stuff up in my life. When God starts shaking some stuff up in your life, stuff starts getting rearranged.
Yep.
The couch go to this side, the table go to this side, the TV go to this side. Why? Because God is moving stuff around. Do you hear me? God, I need you to shake some stuff up on God. I don't got the power to move it. I need you to shake some stuff up on God. I need a Holy Ghost shake. Shake us on God. Shake us in our spirit on God. Wake us up out of sleep on God. Wake us up out of trouble on God. God, I need you on God to shake on God. Turmoil. God, what's going on? Because God is shaking. And God is breathing the stuff from the bottom up to the top. Do you hear me? This is when you come into the house of God. And the preacher is preaching. And it seems like he's picking on you. But it ain't nothing but God causing stuff from the bottom to come up to the top. Oh, it's a Holy Ghost shake. Somebody says, it's a Holy Ghost shake. Shake me, oh God. Shake me, oh God.
Jesus.
And when they come up to the top, they will reach in there and pick out grass seeds. Because some of us need certain seeds picked out of our hearts. I'm talking about stuff, seeds that have been planted in our spirit. That have jacked our spirit over so many years. I'm talking about that man who told you that you ain't gonna be nothing and ain't nobody gonna want you. That seed been planted in your heart for so long. I'm talking about when your mother and your father, they reject you, said they didn't want you. Guess what? That seed been planted down on the inside of your heart for so many years. And this is the reason why come you so mean, you so hateful, you can't trust nobody, you got walls up, you don't die, because the enemy have planted some seeds in your spirit throughout the rest of your life. But let me tell you something, you need the Holy Ghost to reach down inside your heart and pull up everything that's not like God, and let the Holy Ghost begin to remove the seeds. The lies that the enemy placed there, they will pick stuff out until it was nothing but grain, nothing but fruit. God wants you to bear fruit. He want to see fruit. But they will get their chaff was something that was not needed. Do you hear me, saints of God? They will get that chaff, take that chaff, and put that chaff in the oven, and they will burn their chaff up. Do you hear me, saints of God? With fire.
With fire.
This will come. I told you that you need Holy Ghost and fire. The chaff was the husky stuff that was over the grain. You couldn't hardly see the grain because of this scaly, husky stuff. But when the chaff is removed, they get the chaff and put it in the fire. You need Holy Ghost and fire to remove the chaff.
Yes,
I told you chaff was scaly stuff that was over the wheat. And some of us is covered. That's how come people really can't see the real you in God. Because you covered with so much stuff. But the fire of God is a purifier. It brings about purification. This is the reason why come we need the Holy Ghost and fire. Because I need God to purify my life. Do you hear me? I got some stuff on me, and God, I need you to burn it out for God. I don't got the script to remove it, but I need Holy Ghost and fire to burn out everything that's not like God. I don't judge me right now. I'm in a process. Do you hear me? The Holy Ghost and fire is flowing in my life. Do you hear me? God is burning everything out of my life that's not like Him.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know what Sean.
Thank you, Jesus.
You need to be, baby, get on the keyboard, baptized,
yes, Lord,
and Holy Ghost and fire.
Holy Ghost and fire.